Good morning, friends. We are here to discuss the essay class. So as you know, this is first class where we'll be learning number of things, how to ultimately write the essay, what are the things, what are the mistakes we are doing, which are the mistakes we have to avoid. Essay writing, if you talk about, I have before also, if you remember in the orientation class, I talked about that any writing is a communication. And when we are doing essay writing, it is again what? It is a form of communication. We are communicating to some person. Here that person whom we are communicating to is the examiner. So that means we have to do what? We have to be very, very clear in what we are saying. If there is lack of clarity, then what will happen? Our essay won't have that type of impact. Now, I don't need to talk about the significance of the essay. You know very well, it is very important part of our preparation. And you will be ultimately, should be answering 250 marks paper on the basis of essay. But the significance of essay actually goes beyond just the examination. The significance of essay, if you are in the service, even if you are not in the service, then also this essay writing is the key, because throughout our life we have to write something or other things, and in that context this developing this ability to write is very, very crucial. Now if we talk about essay, number of things we will be talking about. We will, like for example, today we will talk about we'll be starting with some basics of essay writing. What we will do, these basics, we will take up some examples to ultimately prove that what we are talking about, how we are learning. In fact, later we will also one essay will just apply these basics that we have learned. Okay? That is basically our task that is there for today. So number of things about essay writing we should be knowing. And if I just talk about these number of things that we should be doing within the essay writing, what is the first problem that we find when we are talking about essay? What is the biggest mistake? If I just start with the biggest mistake, biggest problem that is there with that of writing essay, who will tell me what can be the biggest mistake we can do? Choosing the topic. Okay, we'll come to that, all those things. We'll go into all those things. Okay. What do you think is the biggest mistake, biggest problem because of which students, they are not performing well in the essay? Structuring of ideas, okay. If you ask me the biggest problem that is there, it is that the state of inertia. It is the biggest problem that is there. And what is happening? We are waiting for that perfect moment to ultimately start writing an essay. And that perfect moment is associated with what? That perfect moment is associated with when I have sufficient content. This is the main problem. you have to understand that there is some point, no matter how much, where you are, there is some point you will have to start over. And unless you start over, because see, we want to produce very good essays, no doubt, that is our objective. Essays which are very impressive, which are fetching us at least 140, 150 marks, that is our target. But will we reach that target without starting over? There will be, like for example, this is 150 marks and we want to cross beyond this, go beyond this. But can I say that there is here 0 marks and there would be different people lying in this continuum at different places? You cannot, if you are here, you cannot directly reach daydreaming here. If you want to reach, you will have to continuously keep on practicing. And then only what will happen? Then only you will make progress. And you will keep on progressing in this continuum. It is up to you, you make this progress during the examination hall. So, pehle attempt mein diya to number thode kam aaye, next year mein thoda sa maturity, there was some maturity and again I improved. Or you can do the same thing by practicing. Simply before the examination, if you practice well, clearly it will happen that your progress in this would be what? It would be slowly, gradually it would be taking place. So first thing that we have to do, first thing that we are learning today, it is essentially what? We have to, without hesitation, what we have to do? We have to start writing anything. Here I am saying essay. Start writing the essay. So I will not wait for the content. If suppose I feel like in some area my content is weak, what I will do? I will choose some other area. There are so many, if you talk about topics which are there, which are, if I just pick up previous year papers on essay, there will be so many types of essays where I will be finding the content is very, very general. And there what I need, I don't need too much of information. I can just share my experiences. And again, what will happen? That is what I need. I need to start writing essay. Because until and unless I start the process, my progression in this wouldn't be taking place. I have to progress. And it will not be in one day this progression will be taking place. In fact, when you start writing the essay, you will find that in the initial days, you are not making much of progress. Although you will see that you will be actually making later on. Because when we are doing something, there is what? There is small, small improvements which take place. When we are continuous in something, when we are continuous in our activities. So small, small increments will be there. And suddenly when you have practiced the essay for about 1 month or 20 days, 25 days, 40 days, depending upon where you are, you will see how big change has come up. So the biggest thing, that biggest mistake that we are doing is we are not writing essays. We are not practicing essays. We are still in the state of inertia, and that is the biggest problem. Because once you start, you will find your weaknesses. All those things which you are talking about. Like some of you said, structuring of ideas. How will you know whether you are structuring the ideas well or not until unless you have written the essay and you have got it checked by somebody? Will you be able to know? It is not possible. So the first thing that we have to start, first thing that we have to do is, without wasting of time, we have to do what? We have to start writing essay. So as we said, during these classes, it would be normal to you that you will be writing 6 essays in a week. So you know very well, these 6 essays in a week, there would be, like for example, today we will be just practicing or we'll just discuss one essay. But normally you will be finding that every day, Saturday, Sunday classes are there in a week. So two essays on Saturday, two essays on Sunday, then the week is ending on Friday. That module is ending on Friday with a test, which would be like the UPSC test, where you'll have to choose again among the essays and again you will be writing two. Theek hai? So this is my approach that is going to be there. But even after the classes are over, for example, our classes will be over in the month of July. Even after the classes are over, I have to write the exam. If I stop, again what will happen? If I stop, can I say my progression here will also stop? Because you are not going to reach this level in few days. You will have to keep on practicing. So even after the, if you talk about the time of the classes is over, you have to keep on writing. Like for example, if you have problem, like which topics to choose, there will be another session, another classes. Well, like for example, your classes will end in July. We'll have another batch because it will go on in cycles. So July, August batch, there again we'll give new topics of essay. You collect those topics from the office, you keep on writing. Okay, but you have to keep this activity, keep doing this activity again and again. Every week you have to keep doing this activity, and the more you do, the better you will become. It is, you know, practice makes you perfect, and here also that is what we have to do. You have to keep on writing the essay. Okay, I cannot, this is something which cannot be overemphasized. It is so much important. Okay, this mistake I will not be doing, that I will not practice. Now when it comes to practice, we are saying that practice is the key. When it comes to practice, I am saying writing, you write 6 essays in a week. That is what I am practically saying to you. Okay. Now what we will be finding, that we also have to study number of other things. We have to study our GS, we have to study our optionals. So it might happen that actually when I am writing 6 essays, it might be taking too much of time for me. So what I will do, I will follow a very practical approach, and this approach would be very, very useful. What I will do, for out of this 4 essays, and I will divide 2 essays. These 4 essays, what I will do, I will focus on only on brainstorming and frameworking. Okay, we will see there are 2 stages of essay writing. First we are choosing the topic, and when we have chosen the topic, then we start writing the essay. After that, what we are doing, we are writing the essay in 2 phases. One is this phase of brainstorming and frameworking. Without just starting to write, what we have to do? We have to brainstorm and framework our essays. And it is like, we will see, we'll today see how brainstorming is done. Ultimately, once this is ready, brainstorming and frameworking, in fact we will see that when we are writing essay, we have got 90 minutes to write the essay. Out of this, I am thinking that about 5 minutes I have spent on choosing the topic. 5 to 10 minutes I spent on choosing the topic. So I now have got only 80 minutes. Out of this 80 minute, it is pretty much clear that what I will do, I will spend some 30-35 minutes on the phenomena of this frameworking and brainstorming. rest of the time that is available with me, that is 50 to 45 minutes, that is the time I will be writing an essay. Okay? That is the time I will be writing my essay. So, what I can do? Can I say, ek simple sa cheez hai, you tell me, when I am doing this and I have made the framework, like for example, I have already decided what will be there in the introduction, what will be the idea, main idea along which I will be writing my introduction. I have already decided I am taking a definite approach or an, if you talk about other type of approaches, like for example, I am taking example approach, which is referred to as the anecdote approach. Okay, which approach I am taking? I have already decided which idea my introduction would be. Then I have already decided in the main body what I have to do. I have decided how many parts in the main body would be there, what would be the sequence of these parts, what would be the headings, and what I will be writing within the headings I have already decided. And I have decided that what I will be writing in the conclusion. So, ek tarah se mera essay to tayar ho gaya hai. Only what I have to do, I have to just put it in the words. Theek hai? So, when I am doing this activity 30 minutes or even 40 minutes, can I say I am actually writing an essay without using too much of writing? I am actually writing an essay. So, what we will be doing, we will be writing our four essays. We'll be doing for our four essays this first part. And two essays every week, what we'll do, we'll write them in full, like the conditions of the examination, within that fixed time limit. There also we'll follow the time limit. But here we have to follow the full time limit, brainstorming time and the writing time, like we are sitting in the examination. Okay? So in this manner, you calculate how much time you are actually giving to writing six essays. For four essays, at maximum you will be giving 160 minutes. If you are giving 40 minutes for the brainstorming time. And in this 160 minute, what you will do? You will be able to write, if you talk about your four essays, practice four essays. Okay? This is the approach we are going to follow in the classes also. Okay? So, like for example, tomorrow some IR topics we are planning for tomorrow. Okay? And in this, the teacher will come and he will just tell you something about how to write the ideas of when it is coming to international relations. What would be the basics of this theme of writing on international relations? What is the examiner expecting from you? He will just tell you the theme. Then we'll be taking two essays on one day, and you will be getting time to brainstorm that 30 minute time. You'll be getting, again you'll be getting that 30 minute time for that essay 1 and essay 2. And in this 30 minute you will have to do this activity in the class itself. Okay? And after that, what will happen? The examiner will discuss how he would come, how he would have brainstormed, how he would have thought on the topic. Okay? So this is our very clear approach that we are basically going to follow. Is there any problem? Okay. As I said, even after the classes are over, you should continue with this aspect. So, biggest mistake we will not do, we will start writing the essay from today itself. That is what I said, from today. So we'll take one topic and we'll just today also do some brainstorming in the class. Okay? So that is first thing. Now, when we are writing the essay, there are a number of other things that we have to do. First step in essay writing is the most important step. And if we talk about step 1, it is very clearly choice of the topic. Choice of the topic. Now, I can tell you this experience of mine, my personal experience. It was, if I remember correctly, it was my third attempt. And third attempt, I really felt that I was very much prepared, very good preparation levels were there. I couldn't sleep properly during the night time. I went to the exam, and our time, first paper used to be the essay paper. So we went into the examination, I went into the examination, I started writing the essay I chose. Suddenly, I started writing, I thought on that. I felt after about half an hour that I am not very comfortable with this topic which I have chosen. And it was like a blunder, a very big blunder happened. I had no choice but to do what? And luckily in our case, there used to be only one essay to write. So I had no choice but to stop and choose another topic, because I felt I won't be able to write very, very good essay on this topic. And that blunder, you cannot understand, my marks, which used to be always 120 plus, they went to 90. In 90s my marks went. And why it happened? Because I felt that the biggest blunder I did was I didn't choose the topic properly. And then there was rushing towards the end, and ultimately as a result of which it wasn't good. So what I will be doing, I will first of all take, first step is clearly out of the 90 minutes that I am getting, my first 10 minutes would be spent on choice of the topic, choosing the topic. Okay. Now, when I am choosing the topic, it is very clearly some things you have to keep in mind. And if you talk about these things which you have to keep in mind, my advice is choose a topic for which you have some kind of experience. Some kind of experience. If I have some type of experience. Okay. So again, like for example, one of the biggest mistakes which the students are doing here is they would choose topic related with optionals. Related with optional subject. And what is the basic idea? Basic idea is here that I have good content on this topic. And because of that, we are choosing the optional topic. But you tell me, if I have to ask you, if suppose you were checking the copy of a person who is bringing, writing an essay and showing it to you. There are two essays. One person is showing another, another one is showing another. Out of these two essays, one has just copied, or it is more like normal things which you are reading in some theory or something like that, some ideas. And the second person is presenting some original thing, something which is not written in book, something which is he is thinking and creating. Which of these you feel is better? Can I say the second one? Where there is better creativity. So one of the parameters we will find that we judge in case of essay writing is the parameter of creativity. Now you tell me, it is very simple. Suppose ki main exam dene gaya, theek hai? And there is one question, question number one, there is question number two. I am prepared for question number one, but question number two, this topic I was not prepared, but both are compulsory. in which of these you will tend to be more creative? Can I say it would be the second one? Okay. Because I was not prepared, I have no other choice but to become more creative. Although it is an example of a forced creativity, but it is there. It is obvious that I will be more creative here in the second question. That is what is the problem. When we have knowledge, information, which is generally we find, about something, about that idea, what is the problem? It is behaving, that knowledge is behaving like a barrier of creativity, barrier to our creativity. We are unable to think beyond, and we already have what? We have already a structured line of thought, and along this structured line of thought, what we are doing? We are just starting to write the essay. We just are unable to produce new things in that. So what type of topics I have to choose? The type of topics that I have to choose is those which are more close to me. Close to me. Like for example, suppose if I have to choose between international relation topic and there is one essay on topic of education. Now you tell me which of these actually I have experienced in my life. This topic of education, ek tarah se bolun to we are all victims of this education policy that is there in India. We have suffered and we have learnt. We have gained. Can I say I will be able to bring out many of my own experiences with respect to education? Many of the problems which I would have faced, many of the things which I felt need to be improved. My interaction with the teachers, my interaction, my experiences in the university. Okay? So, I will be choosing which topic? I will be choosing the topic of education. Okay? Like, for example, if we just look into one minute. There was one essay which we will be practicing today. And this essay is our deeds determine as much as we determine our deeds. Okay? So we will be practicing this essay and this is our deeds determine us as much as we determine our deeds. As much as we determine our deeds. Okay? Now, can I say, if suppose aisa koi topic mere samne aa jayega, I will think, ultimately, it is pretty much clear that this is something which I am experiencing every day in my life. Can I say that? I am experiencing everywhere this phenomena. That what I am doing, I am becoming like that. If I am studying hard, what is the level of my confidence? Can I say it improves? You might have experienced, you are preparing for the examination. There might be days when you are very low and you are not studying, you'll feel like I'll take a break from studies. And aksar aisa hota hai ki the break extends, it becomes too much, Many days I am just like wasting time. And when I am wasting time, can I say what is the confidence level of mine? It is becoming low. So this is I am experiencing every day. Our deeds are determining us. It is very clear that it was my choice. I still had the factor of choice. It was my choose. I could have still gone for studies. I could haven't given up. It is something I am experiencing every day. I am seeing in my practical life everywhere. So, if I was writing an essay, I will choose such type of essays on more personal themes. These are the essays on personal theme. Okay? So I really feel like, for example, I have tested this and I will be doing later on. I'll list of topics of essays given to you, and what you are doing, you choose. For example, I gave in a class a list of essays, and there was one topic like which related with the status of women in the society. ठीक है, अब guess मारो कि सबसे ज़्यादा उस topic को किसने choose किया होगा? लड़कों ने. How you can experience that feminism? The theme of the topic was on feminism. It is difficult for you to actually visualize that feminism. Because you cannot be a woman. You cannot think like a woman. And thus, there can be some feminist people. They would have known others. Like I knowing my mother, I knowing my sister, I knowing my friends very well. So I might be, okay, I'm comfortable. I know how they think. But still, I cannot be very sure that I know exactly. So why not choose something which is more closer to you? Rather than just thinking, why the students were choosing that? Because they would be able to write that women are facing this problem, this social problem, they have studied in GS. All that information is there. And thus, they would put that information, they will feel I have written a very good essay. But will you be able to give personal examples? Very difficult in that case. We will see that one of the aspects which fetches very good marks, it is the aspect of personal examples. Stories in the essay. So I have to choose the topic very, very wisely. I have to remember the thing that what are the things which are giving me good marks, where I will be able to do those things, in which topic I have more choice, more liberty of doing those type of things, giving personal examples, giving stories, other. You should be always writing in the first person, ideally speaking, because that will make it your essay. Okay? Like for example, very good question you have asked. I'll give you this idea. You go home, go after the class to the market, to a bookshop, and there you buy two novels. I'll tell you. One novel is any of these you can buy, like for example, you can buy Alchemist. Many of you might have read. Okay? You buy Alchemist. And you buy another novel which I have read and I couldn't complete the novel because it was so boring for me. And this was a very famous novel, Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. The difference you will be finding, that Alchemist is totally enchanting. It captures you. Because ultimately what happens, there it is writing in the first person. The story writer is like himself telling his story. And when you read, you feel like you are that person, that boy, about this, about whom the story is. And you feel like you are in the moment. On the other hand, if you take the other case, there the writer is telling about a story about somebody else. A person who was rich, he later became monk in search of the happiness that he was going for. And you will find that the first approach, it is much more capturing. Okay? So when you are writing, my advice is, we'll see, abhi dekhenge, we will be writing in what? We'll be writing in the first person. It is much, much better. Okay? Because that will also give me originality. Originality of ideas. Although if I don't have such examples, I can definitely write also some examples in second person. But try to be writing in, write in the first person itself. Okay? So, we'll come to that thing later. First is the topic choice, choice of the topic. So what I will do, I will give first the basic idea. So, mera steps kaise honge? If I was suppose writing the essay, I will choose first of all, I will eliminate. Eliminate. And what I will do? I will ultimately, first of all, eliminate which of these I am not going to write. Can I say this activity can be done in 1 minute? Which of these I am not going to write? This activity can be done in 1 minute. And I will see that, okay, this is like, I will become too technical. I don't have so much examples. I cannot be too much creative in this topic. So all those topics where I feel my approach would become mechanistic. Mechanistic. What I will do? I will simply eliminate them. I will eliminate them. Okay? Then there might be one or two topics where I would have doubt that which one I am going to write. Okay? So there would be, suppose there is confusion between two topics. There is confusion between two topics. So what I will do? Can I say if I have confusion, I should give 2 to 3 minutes at least on each of the topics. And in this 2 to 3 minutes, can I say I should just think about the broad idea. It is broad idea which this statement is talking about. I will talk about the broad idea. Okay? And in which I have become more comfortable, I feel more comfortability. What I will do? I will choose that idea. If I make a mistake here, you know very well what is going to happen. If you make a mistake here, it will all be gone. Okay? All these things we will be doing in the class. What I am saying, at this point, we'll have lots of examples in the classes later on. Okay? And it is just the, if I just tell you, the aspect of this class is to help you learn how to practice writing essay. Okay? Rather than just giving you those ideal essays. Okay? So that is the first step that I will have to take, the choice of the topic. And if you ask me, even if you spend out of 90 minutes, even if you are spending 10 minutes on choice of the topic, it is actually justified. Because if I make the mistake here, it cannot be corrected in the contemporary scenario where I have got just 90 minutes. Okay? So that is the first step. Now, few more things that we'll be talking about. Once I have chosen the topic, my next step is what? my next step is to clearly start phenomena of brainstorming. The phenomena of brainstorming. And frameworking. The phenomena of brainstorming and frameworking. Now, if we look into our mind, how our mind works, our mind is working very randomly. The ideas flow in a very random manner. Okay? So, what I will do when I'm brainstorming, I know that my mind is random, it is randomly working. So why not, when I'm jotting down the ideas, I take this page and I jot down on the page, not in a sequence, like my ideas are flowing. I don't restrict when I'm writing, when actually I make sequence, what basically I am doing, I am restricting my mind. Okay? So what I have to do, when I'm doing the brainstorming, I will take the page, on that page, I will write the ideas randomly, not in a sequence. This is very important aspect of brainstorming. Because this is how our mind always works. If I write in sequence, it would restrict my mind. My thinking would be restricted. Okay? This is how I have to do the aspect of brainstorming. Now, there would be steps in brainstorming. First step of brainstorming is what I call it as the random brainstorming. Second, if you talk about, is the choice of themes, of paragraphs. Paragraphs and sequence of paragraphs. So in the second level, what I will do? I will choose. So I have, you can see here. Suppose I have clearly accumulated lots of ideas. And what I can do? I can choose, okay, this one can be heading of my paragraph. This idea is good, that can be a heading of my paragraph. This idea is good, another, it can be a heading of my paragraph. So I'll choose which of these are going to be the headings of my paragraph. And when I'm saying using the word heading, I don't have to write heading. That means theme of the paragraph. And I've done this, what I will do? Can I say, then I will also give number. Like, for example, I feel like this should come first. This idea should be coming second. This idea should be coming third. This should be coming fourth. So I'll also think about what should be the logical sequence. Logical sequence. And once I have decided, then can I say, I will talk about the third level, that is brainstorming on the themes of paragraphs. I call this stage as the sequential brainstorming. It is a sequential brainstorming. And here, because now our ideas are more structured and we basically know what we have to write inside. When we are thinking about this level, you know very well, you'll think about the content, you'll think about the examples, if there is story, anything, quotations, you can write any of these, we'll see. But these are the three stages in which you essentially have to do the brainstorming aspect. Okay? If I say, "Hamare paas kitne minute hai?" I am assuming that I have got about 35 minutes for this activity, because 45 minutes I am going to give to write the essay. So I have got 35 minutes to do this activity. Okay. When I am doing this random brainstorming, I will be giving the first altogether 15 to 20 minutes, or it would be ideal if you give 15 minutes to this level of brainstorming. Okay. Then can I say I can give 5 minutes, because I have already arranged the ideas, or I have got the ideas already. So next I will do what? In next 5 minutes I will be choosing the themes, which would become the themes of my paragraph. Then I have got 15 minutes more. In the next 15 minutes I will brainstorm on each of those themes further. Each of these themes further. Okay? So this is what I am going to do. Ab karte hain isko. Let us do this. Let us take our topic. Jo humne apna topic uthaya tha. So our topic was, our deeds determine us as much as we determine our deeds. So we will be doing that in the same sequence that we said. So our first 15 minutes starts here. Okay. So now in my watch, if I say, it is 10:47 in my watch. That means I will do this activity up till 11:02. Okay. So you start doing the first level. Remember what you have to do? You have to think randomly, you have to, on the page, you have to write randomly. अब आज नहीं हो पाएगा, आज नहीं कर पाएंगे। Your 10 minutes are over. Okay. So I saw many of you doing this brainstorming, but again, you would have thought how much we are trained to just restrict ourselves. I saw many of you just writing straight. You just have to think very randomly. Be very random on the page. As much as random you can. You'll see. If you practice this, sometimes it is like things are linked to each other. So, if we are like happy, we'll feel good. Can I say that? But sometimes, if I forcefully become happy, I'll again feel good. Okay? So sometimes we have to force some things. Now, here, I would have, if I was doing this activity, I would have thought it in a number of ways. There were some aspects first I would have looked into. Just before I start thinking, I would start first look into the statement properly. That what this statement was all about. And if I look into the statement, I would come to few conclusions, few things. Like for example, it is a, can I say it is an abstract statement? Can I say that? First of all, it is an abstract statement. Now, in such abstract statement, I will have to choose my side. I will be affirmative, I will be partially affirmative, or I will be negative. Okay, I have three choices. I can be affirmative. This is one approach I can take. I can be partially affirmative, and I can be negative. Can I say which approach was most suitable here? Can I say here it was affirmative approach should have been taken? Because the statement is seems to be very perfectly correct. That holds good with our the idea of our society, the ethics, the values that we have learnt in the society. In any society, this is the ethical aspect which is taught to the people. That you do good and everything will be good. Okay. So I will very clearly here choose what? That I have to be affirmative in writing my essay. Okay. Now, another thing, here in, if I look into this statement, can I see that statement actually has two parts which are linked to each other? And it is deeds determining us. Can I say this is one part of the statement? Second, we determining our deeds. And these are what? These are casually linked to each other. These two aspects are casually linked to each other. So, it is simply saying that deeds are determining us and we are also determining our deeds. Our deeds are determining us and we also determine our deeds. We have to, that means, if I just write about only this aspect and miss out on this aspect, can I say I will not be writing to the theme of the essay? It is very clear. So when I am writing paragraphs, my themes, can I say in those themes I have to prove both these things, that the deeds are determining us and we also are determining our deeds? Okay? Itna samajh mein aaya? Now, if we further look into this idea, can I say one word that I use was this abstract. It is an abstract statement. Okay. Can I say when I have to put abstract ideas to people, it would be difficult that they will understand me. Keh sakta hun? So when the abstract ideas are to be proved, can I say I should be taking help of some concrete examples? I should be taking help of some concrete examples, informations. Even can I say I can use some story if I don't have examples? Theek hai? Because it is what? It is abstract idea. So there is like abstract idea that we have inside us, good and bad, both. Theek hai? And ultimately it is always the good thing which wins. If I am trying to tell this to some people, they might not actually understand what he is talking about. But if I put this same idea with help of Mahabharat, it was essentially what? It was the same idea. There were Kauravs, there were Pandavs. Pandavs were good, Kauravs were not so good. They were part of the same family. So abstract ideas, when we are putting abstract ideas, it is our duty to do what? To put them with some example, concrete examples. If we don't have those concrete examples, we can definitely put what? Some stories we can make. And we can write about those ideas. Okay? But it is our duty to do this. So this is, can I say, in the first few minutes what I have done? I have decided my approach. What is going to be my approach? It is very clear that I have to be affirmative in my idea. When I am writing my paragraphs, in the paragraphs I will show both the things, that how our deeds determining us and we are determining our deeds. Okay? Now I have to do what? I have to start my brainstorming process. And in this beginning of the brainstorming process, what I will do? I will start thinking now. And if I look into the statement, first I am very random. I am not thinking too much of thought in structured manner. I am very random. So I am thinking, I am just read, okay. There is one, our, us, we. Can we say that? So there is this our, us and we. So if I just think our, us and we. Now, can I start thinking on this? What could be the dimensions of this our, us and we? Soch sakte hain? Theek hai? So like I can think of, I can think that I am individual. Can we give examples of individuals? Ab individual mein bhi main bahut saari cheeze soch sakta hun. I can think of individual being a man, or I can simply say, being a human, or this individual can also be what? Can I say it can also be an animal? Can we say it can also be an animal? Okay. I can think of both humans as well as animals. I can even divide this human into man, women. Okay. I can think like I am like man and women. So again, that is one thing that comes to my mind. Can I say, okay, our, us and we can also be a society? Can I say that? It can also be a society? Can I say it can also be an area or region? It can also be an area or region. Can I say, when we are talking about our, us, we, can we say it can also be a nation? Nation ke terms mein bhi likh sakte hain. So it can also be a nation. Theek hai? Similarly, can I say, when I'm thinking I can go even bigger? We can think of humanity. We don't know how many aliens are living in this world. Okay? So it is what? We can also think of humanity. So first thing what I have done, I know very well one dimension I have got. That, okay, our, us, we. It is so many things it can mean at so many levels. Can I say this? ठीक है बाद में जब मुझे sequencing करनी होगी can I say common theme of our would be what? Normal theme would be a person will think of an individual. So can I say I will be starting with this level? This would be the macro heading. And all this would be what? ये जब मैं when I'm talking about this it is not going to be my main theme. It would be a sub theme. Human ka example de sakta hu. It can be sub themes within this, but they are not going to be my main theme. So if I am doing like this, I can give like 1A, 1B. Theek hai na? Jo second wala step hai hamara, what we were talking about. Similarly, I know when I am talking about individual, I will think of second thing should be what? Can I say it should be society? Should be society. The same society I can think of in terms of area or region. I can think of in terms of area or region. This is the next in the hierarchy. If I go further, I can even isme se bhi I could have taken a smaller hierarchy. Like for example, ek cheez main bhul gaya likhna yahan par. I could have thought about organization. Theek hai? So this would be now becoming second, this would be third. Break kyun chahiye? अभी तो हमने कुछ किया ही नहीं है. विल नॉट बी टेकिंग अ ब्रेक टुडे. ठीक है बिकॉज मेरी एक क्लास है 1:30 पर. सो विल फिनिश ऑफ व्हाट वी आर डूइंग. ठीक है यार विल टेक. अच्छा ठीक है आई विल गिव यू 10 मिनट्स ब्रेक अभी बट लेट अस फर्स्ट यार कम कंप्लीट दिस व्हाट वी वर डूइंग. इज नॉट गुड वी आर लिविंग इन बिटवीन. ओके सो नेशन उसी तरह से आई कैन थिंक ऑफ नेक्स्ट आई कैन थिंक ऑफ दिस ह्यूमैनिटी. ठीक है बट ये वाली एक्टिविटी मैं बाद में कर रहा हूँ. हमारे जो सेकंड स्टेज है वी हैव सीन ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंग शुड बी डन एट थ्री लेवल्स. सो फर्स्ट आई हैव थॉट ऑन दिस टॉपिक ऑफ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ आवर अस एंड वी. ठीक है नाउ अब मेरे को दूसरी चीज पर थिंक करना है. Can I say next thing I should be thinking of can be about I am finding it is talking about deeds. Okay so now I'll start thinking on this idea of deeds and if I think about deeds okay deeds simply means what? Can I say it means my actions? It would essentially mean actions, the things which I'm doing, the practice, some ideas, some words will start coming to my mind, they begin to flow to my mind. But will I think that deed is also thinking? Can I say? Deed is also what? Sometimes, when we are thinking, then also we are doing some activity. Deed is basically what? It is action activity. And when I am thinking, I am essentially doing some activity. If I think bad thoughts, can I say, it is but normal that it would also be reflected in my thought, in my actions. Okay? So when I am thinking, that is also one aspect. Like for example, already I have thought about us, so I know so many things I can talk about, deeds, there from individual point of view, I am thinking like this of deed. Can I say I can think of deeds from a social point of view, like from aspect of nation point of view? Okay. So like for example, if suppose we are talking about one deed, can be statement which has been given by a person, or if India is giving some statement in United Nations, that is also what? That is the deed. Okay? So I will think, what is the meaning of this term deed? Then another word is that I am finding here is determine. Is what is the meaning of this aspect of determination? Okay. So clearly, determine means I'll think that when I'm thinking about determination, it is affecting what? Can I say affecting might be, I can think of my present, my future, affecting my future. In fact, here determine is used in two sense. Okay? One is our deeds are determining us, but we are also determining our deeds. That means we have what? We have element of choice while we are determining. Can I say? That is one aspect I can think of, okay? Individual level, what can be this, what can this mean, what can be some kind of example or things which can be there. Theek hai? So again, what I have done with this activity is, can I say I have broadly thought randomly, first of all, randomly on the terms which are there. Theek hai? Ab jab mere ko ye mil gaya, can I say कि मैंने अपना काम बहुत आसान कर दिया? Already what I have done? अभी तक this looked to be very abstract type of statement, बहुत clarity नहीं हो रहा था what was there in this statement. As soon as I broke this statement into some parts and thought on those lines, on those keywords, I got an idea of what and how to write. ठीक है? So this is my first level, and from this first level, number of things now I have got here. So I have got from this first level, now I am talking about my headings, how I will be linking my headings, what were the key themes that I got. So I got theme of individual, this individual, I saw that it can be humans or other living beings. This is one idea I got. I got that this can be a society, this can be an area, this can be, if you talk about a nation, organization bhi tha, theek hai, there was organization, this could be a nation and this can be the whole humanity. Humanity, theek hai, and it is what? Second thing we were talking about, the deeds, thinking, actions, theek hai. So can I say, ab jab deed ke point of view se, jab main individual ke point of view se baat kar raha hun, deed ko, I am thinking, so I will have to write it in two activities, actions which are being taken and thinking, aisa ban sakta hai, theek hai, organization ke point of view se, can I say, every organization has a kind of policy, that is policy is what, thinking, and the steps taken by the organization, steps taken, ठीक है, so ये thinking वाला point ये हो गया policy, ये हो गया actions. Similarly, when I'm talking about a society, thinking about a society, can I say customs would be that thinking aspect, and again there would be several social practices. Social practices, ठीक है, same is like the case of area, there would be some kind of customs, some kind of practices which would be there. If you talk about nation, can I say nation would have its own policy, or I can say philosophy, can be democratic, non-democratic, it can be one religion state. So this is what, this is the thought, this is the thinking, this is the idea, and several actions here also. Similarly, if I am talking about humanity, can I say number of things I can think about as thinking, as thought, like for example, one thing I can think about is the human rights. It is basically what? It is the idea. There is some kind of universal human rights, for example. ठीक है, so some kind of the philosophy. What is the philosophy of being human? Whether being human means what? You subjugating other living beings, other human beings. Or being human means what? Being the great, the thing which we have been taught that human beings are what? They are great living beings. They are specially created human beings, having that metaphysical perspective. ठीक है? Again, actions. ठीक है? And next I will also talk about the determination. And when I am talking about determining, can I say I have to talk about determining both how we are determining our deeds and deeds are determining us, dono ko lena hai, theek hai, har cheez ke liye I can just think of, isko prove karna hai mujhe, I can write the basic aspect and example, keh sakte hai, that is what I have to do. So I have now broadly come to a framework. Now what I have to do, I just have to think of particular examples which I will be citing. Like for example, if I just take the case of individual, so one of my paragraph heading would be, I will be in main body, I will be essentially talking about what? I will be talking about the level of individual. And when I'm talking about the level of individual, I can give example of humans. Can talk about humans, human beings. So human beings are doing what? Human beings are, I would first put that ultimately it is our actions that make us what? That make us what we are. And it is we who are free to choose as human beings. We are free to choose what actions we are taking. Can I say that I can take example, like for example, if I suppose take example of any, can I say here I can take example of a great person? Both examples I can take. Ek jagah par jahan par achha sochta tha. Other, can I say, I can take example of a situation where the thinking was not so good. So can I say, I can take the example of suppose Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi. So if you talk about Mahatma Gandhi, can I say Mahatma Gandhi ultimately led to what? His idea was basically, his thinking was what? His deed was, he always thought about his non-violence, love, peace, equality. All these things we can write about. That was his thinking. Can I say he showed also in his actions? And it was choice always available to him. He showed this also in his actions. So when, for example, he was fighting for the freedom of India, what he did? Can I say he was taking the case of non-violence? It was non-cooperation, civil disobedience, these type of movements he ran, which were essentially based on what? They were based on his thinking. So what? Yes. You can quote examples if you want. The story examples you can talk about. And we can say that ultimately what he did, he had choice. Like he's saying South Africa case. So when he was thrown out, he had choice that he could have reacted in other manner. He chose to react. He could have been like thought about protesting, thought about not protesting and being like the other people, like the other Indians. But what he did, he didn't decide to be like other Indians. And when he was deciding not to be like other Indians, again he had choice. When he is protesting, when he wants to fight against this injustice, it is still his choice whether he will take the path of violence, because there were people who were taking the path of violence. He could have done what? He could have tried to kill that person who threw him out of the train. He could have tried to find that person, that TC, and he would have tried to take revenge from him. But what he saw? He saw that this is a big problem. And it is problem because people are silent. What should be done? We should protest not against that person. That person is just a player in the bigger scheme of things. And ultimately what happened? He just started this. It was that juncture where he ultimately started his actions. And these actions ultimately made him, can I say, today we are celebrating 2nd October. And it is celebrated world over. He is father of the nation. If you talk about Gandhi, he is quoted as one of the most influential thinkers, philosophers of human society. So here, can we see that it is very clear that the actions he took, ultimately, they were his choice. He was determining his deeds. And these deeds ultimately went on to do what? We say that he got us independence. He is father of the nation. He is so much loved person in the world. So, his deeds determined him. Okay? Can I take another example of human? Like for example, I can take example of Adolf Hitler. I can take example of Adolf Hitler. And if you talk about Hitler, he ultimately came to power in Germany. Now he had very clear choice in front of him. And it was his choice which model he is going to choose. Model of cooperation with other nations, or he is just going to continue with the policy of subjugation of other nations. Okay. Hatred, policy of hatred towards certain class. He could have chosen to integrate if he had, suppose, because Hitler was of the idea that the problem in Germany, many problems in Germany were because of the Jew population, for example. So he could have chose to correct them. Like for example, if you take the case of Gandhi, he also was of the view that there were many bad practices there in the Harijans. He also accepted this, like the problem of drinking, etc. And he accepted it as the bad practice. But did he choose to kill them? Definitely not. His choice was basically what? His choice was to work with them. In fact, he started to call them Harijans. Work with them and work for their upliftment, work for their education. So this same choice, this type of choice could have been of Hitler, but he chose another way. He ultimately created those concentration camps where what was happening, where lots of Jews were being killed. And he chose his deeds. Can I say the outcome of this was what? Outcome of this is Hitler is regarded as the villain in the history of the world. His status is not that of much respect. A common person also uses Hitler o kya? That is the type of status that he has got. Theek hai na? So again, that is the case of individual. I can talk about how the individuals would be there. ठीक है, अब इसमें मैं बहुत सी सारी चीजें दे सकता था. जब हम डिटरमाइन की बात कर रहे थे तो अब वहां पर आई कुड हैव थॉट मोर. वी जस्ट वर शॉर्ट. फॉर एग्जांपल, डिटरमाइन करने के लिए आई कुड हैव थॉट अबाउट ओके एनवायरमेंट क्या डिटरमाइन करता है. एनवायरमेंट, माय इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस, माय सोशल स्टेटस. ठीक है, so there also again while I was brainstorming I would have got so many types of points about determination. Theek hai, so again as an individual I can give this example of how individual a human being is ultimately determining his deed, and you give both the case, good and bad. Theek hai, so again I can think of some individual. Then I can think of an organization. Suppose I think of an organization. Okay? And I take an example, any example of an organization. Kaun sa example le sakte hain? Can you think of right now? You can think of UN, or you can think of some smaller organization. It is not an organization, it was an event. You can talk about that, ultimately that organization. They had the choice to take the corrective steps or not. And ultimately because of that, what happened? there was a disaster which occurred. And the Union Carbide, if you talk about, they had to also what? They had to stop operations. On the other hand, there are organizations, like for example, if I take case of any NGO, for example, like if we take in recent times, so many NGOs are there at work. For example, in Maharashtra, there is Pani Foundation of Amir Khan. So what they're doing, their idea, their thinking is what? Their thinking is that you can create change with your efforts. That is their basic idea. Any problems can be solved. And they're working for solving of the problems of water. And what they're doing? They're creating small water harvesting structures. Now, what is happening because of that? Because of that, they have become very popular organization. They are getting good amount of funds. Today, there is so many international agencies who are willing to fund them. Okay? So I can take example of organization. I can take example of a society. Society ka example le sakta hun. Like for example, I can compare two type of societies. One is the traditional society, like some kind of orthodox traditional society, like a society which is functioned by the Khap Panchayat, for example. Okay? There it is the Khap which is the deciding factor. So that ultimately what will happen? That society will be deciding. So suppose if there are two people belonging to different caste and they are willing to marry, they love each other. Again, it is the choice of the society to ultimately do what? Can I say? To ultimately either allow this marriage or to not allow this marriage. It is the choice of the society to ultimately follow the traditional customs or to evolve. Evolve. And follow more modern approach. And in modern ideas, it is very clear that these type of boundaries between people have to be removed. The caste barriers, the religion barriers, they have to be what? They have to be removed between people. So it is still the choice of the society, which choice it is taking up. And can I say, it is pretty much clear that I can give example, like if they choose to ultimately go for the customary morality, the traditional customs, follow the traditional customs, can I say, it is very common that couple who have forcefully married, they are even killed. And can I say, if this type of situation is taking place, there can be rights in the society? Have happened in the past. Caste, upper caste, like for example, this phenomena, similar type of phenomena occurred in the case of Western UP, where there were rights. And because of that, what happened to the stability of the society? Can I say the stability of the society was disturbed? If you go still in those areas of Western UP, you will be finding that ultimately the situation has not returned to normal. It is still not peaceful. There's still so much tension. So it was what? It was the society which decided which course of action to take. And this action ultimately did what? It gave bad name to the society. It ultimately threatened the existence of the society, stability of the society. Okay? So I can give example. Similarly, if I take the case of area, can I say, I can think of that today one big problem is that of environment. Environmental problems are arising. And now each area has a choice of which actions, which deeds to make. It would be guided by environmental preservation or the philosophy of sustainable development, or it would be guided by philosophy of economic development. Do tarah ki philosophy ho sakti hai. And each would have what? Each would have its own ultimately outcome. Theek hai? Like for example, if you take the case of, in many areas we are finding, you take the case of Chennai. Chennai. So what happened in Chennai? They did not follow the sustainable development strategy. And what was the outcome? In fact, if I just give you a specific example, Chennai, what it did, the urban sprawl of Chennai occurred over natural areas. The areas which were like the lakes, ponds, and these are areas of what? They are areas of water harvesting, where water is stored. They led to what? They led to cutting down of the trees, water harvesting structures, other water harvesting structures were disturbed, and there was increasing concretization done. As a result of what happened? Can I say we saw they chose their policy, they chose their deeds, and ultimately what happened? Very devastating Chennai floods. Another example I can give, like Uttarakhand example. So in Uttarakhand, what has happened? There has been permission given to too many dams, too many small dams, mini dams, micro dams. Theek hai? Now, this is becoming a problem, because if you are making too many small, mini, micro dams, this means what? You'll be affecting the speed of the flow of river. And if you are affecting the speed of the flow of the river, it means that if suppose there is an episode of heavy rainfall, the water cannot flow out. And this would mean what? Can I say it would mean floods and landslides? So they have chosen their deeds. Ultimately, as a result of which, what is taking place? There is so much flooding and landslides problem in recent times. This phenomena has accelerated. It has increased the frequency as well as intensity of these events have what? They have increased. Okay? On the other hand, there can be states like Sikkim. And Sikkim is going for what? It is going for a full organic state. And can I say, result is very clear that Sikkim is being awarded for this. It has got so many awards. What has happened? Even international agencies are very much interested in this model. They are looking into this model. There is funding going on. Okay? So again, what is your philosophy? That thinking will decide your actions. And ultimately, these actions are our choice. It is our thinking which is doing this action. And these actions will in turn do what? They would in turn decide our future. Okay? So I can think of concrete example. Kyunki humne pehle hi bataya tha, this is an abstract statement. Abstract statements need to be proved with concrete examples. Similarly, if I'm talking about a nation, can I take examples? Like, for example, I can take the case of North Korea, South Korea. Okay, very good example. Both of these are part of their Korea. Okay, they have, however, the choice element. Which of the choice to take? One is more democratic nation, South Korea, while North Korea remained what? It remained autocratic. So they decided their deeds. They had choice to take. The society, the leaders had choice to make. And they chose which path they would be going. Can we see that these deeds have determined what is the level, what is the future of these countries? So today, South Korea is what? It is one of the industrialized nations. It is one of the countries which is very technology oriented, very If you talk about industries particularly related with automobile, machinery, electronics, various type of industries, it is what? They are very highly developed in South Korea. On the other hand, can I say North Korea is still dependent upon aid? Like for example, lots of their food, if you talk about, they are unable to supply their food. China is in fact supplying them lots of food. There is ban imposed on North Korea today. It is seen as what? Threat to the world. US characterized it as the states under axis of evils. Bad force. They can destabilize. It is seen as some country which can cause the end of the earth. It is seen as that type of nation. So I can essentially talk about being that type of nation. When I'm talking about humanity, can I take the example of the idea of climate change, environmental degradation? So as human beings, what we have done? Can I say, 20th, after industrial revolution, we have essentially followed the philosophy of, if based our idea of that economy is more important to us. Economic development is more important than preservation of environment. And we have believed ourselves mostly in technology. And the idea, basic idea is technology will take care of all the problems. So this is our thinking. Can I say this type of thinking, because of this, we are choosing our action. And our action has been what? Can I say our action is very clear? We have emitted so many greenhouse gases in the environment. We are making very fast land use changes, removing forests, removing biodiversity. So these are what? These are our actions. And these actions have brought us where? Can we say that these actions have brought us ultimately to a verge of, already we saw extinction episodes, they have accelerated. There is very fast climate change. IPCC is talking that if we are unable to restrict the climate change to 1.5 degrees Celsius, what will happen? So many big type of problems would be arriving. At number of places, human beings' own existence is what? Threatened. Can I say there is threat? Like for example, you take the case of new rising diseases. They have potential of wiping out entire humanity. Many of these are actually coming because the ice is melting and the viruses and other things which are trapped in the ice, they are now becoming what? They are becoming free. So again what? It is our choice. Which type of future we want? I can give example. I'm very frequently giving example this. Either our future is to be like the prokaryote or the eukaryote bacteria. The prokaryote bacteria, they created an environment which was oxygen rich. And ultimately what happened? They could not themselves survive. So what is going to be our future? Are we going to be the humanity if we talk about? Are we going to be that ultimate thing which we think we are? We think that we are specially created species. So are we going to be that human being? Or we are going to be just another species which got extinct? It is our choice. What we are deciding, that will, these deeds would decide our future. Can I say, seeing this only, today we are talking about phenomena of sustainable development. Today we are talking that all countries should take steps to curb the problem of climate change. In fact, many places, can I say, our deeds have given us huge success. Can we cite the example of Montreal Protocol? Because of the actions which were taken under Montreal Protocol, what has happened? Can I say we are filling the ozone hole? There is evidence now the ozone hole is filling up. There is repair taking place. So I can give both example, good and bad. Itna likhunga, to can I say that I would have actually crossed that 1000 word limit, which we were thinking, 1000 to 1200 word limits. Now, when you actually first saw the statement, did you think that you would be able to write this much? How many of you think you will be able to write like this, this much? You knew so much about. Now, when I'm talking, can you see how much you actually knew about this statement? But this statement was like what? Just because we are trained to think that we know only those things which are mechanical, those mechanistic type of knowledge. And if I'm writing this essay like this, you tell me, can I say I will be getting better marks? It is very obvious, yaar. You have just, this is your essay which you are producing. Okay? It is very obvious you will be getting very good marks. So this is one way I could have written this essay. Yes. Yes, that is what I am saying. Many personal themes which we practice. It can happen that these same personal themes can be asked in the examination in just some other terms. And many of the examples, ideas that you use, they can be directly used there. Okay? Okay, but kyunki is essay mein kuch hai nahi na. It is, this essay is just an abstract idea, one abstract idea ki what is there, hum apne actions ko decide kar rahe hain and actions hamare future ko decide kar raha hai, theek hai. So there is this cyclic relationship which is there. Yeah, matlab it is your choice, I am just giving you a framework. अब इसको अभी हम देखते हैं कि हम और भी कैसे कैसे चेंज कर सकते हैं या ब्यूटीफाई कर सकते हैं. बट आई वॉज वी हियर वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट द प्रोसेस ऑफ ब्रेकिंग थिंग डाउन. अभी तो हम केवल ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंग पर ही बात कर रहे हैं. हमारा फर्स्ट स्टेप, इनफैक्ट सेकेंड स्टेप आफ्टर वी हैव मेड द चॉइस ऑफ द एसे. सो विद दिस व्हाट वी हैव डन, नाउ वी हैव गॉट, कैन आई से नाउ आई हैव डायरेक्शन वेयर टू टेक. हमने सबसे पहले क्या किया, what was the aspect which we did first, can I say ki humne sabse pehle apna conclusion decide kar liya tha. What we did, we had to take out of three choices, affirmative, partially affirmative and negative. Usme se what we did, the first step was we decided what is going to be our conclusion, that means hamara destination kya hai, and we had to make a path to reach that destination. And I made the choice that I am going to conform to the statement. I will be affirmative with the statement. I will agree with the statement. Okay? Now when I have to make agreement, that means I have to prove that this statement is correct. So in my entire essay, what I was doing? I was going towards that final objective of proving that this statement is correct. ठीक है. Now अगर मुझे इसमें philosophy में और थोड़ा जाना है, you can go in the conclusion, वहां चले जाओ कि actually में it is a very complicated system. Individuals make society, societies make area, areas if you talk about are making nations, and nations make what? Nations make humanity. So ultimately what we are finding, the deeds of an individual, deeds at individual level, deeds at organizational level, deeds at social level, regional level, national level, are ultimately what? They are determining the deeds or the future of humanity. What is going to be ultimately future of humanity. In the conclusion, I can even link like this. So if we have to go reach a better future of humanity, we have to ensure that humanity survives. Can I say we have to ensure that our deeds at individual level, people are taught what is good, what is bad, or they are taught to be like thinking on some kind of such lines, some moral lines. Similarly, there should be what? Organization should be also working within such parameters of morality. Are we really independent to determine our deeds? That is what we are saying, na? Now, theek hai, what you are saying is correct. That is also one, if you talk about point of view, you can take up while you are discussing your essay. That means, in that case, ye ek approach hai. Theek hai? Here we were taking which approach? Affirmative approach. I can be take, agar mera conclusion dusra hota, yahan par maine bola na, ek example I just have presented. If my conclusion was different, if my conclusion was partially affirmative, then I will be not writing like this of just proving it down. Then what I will be doing? I will be taking the other aspect also. Like for example, I will talk about, then I will take different examples. I will also think in an AC framework mein I can talk about like. So many times people are like, if I take individual example, people are causing damage to environment. For example, in rural areas, you'll be finding people are cutting down trees. Okay? Or there is phenomena of open defecation. Okay? And when there is this phenomena of open defecation, what will happen? There is a problem arising. But do people have choice? There might be so much poverty. Because of that phenomena of open defecation is there. Okay? So again, I can put that idea also when it is partially affirmative. It was just one example. Because, and what you said, it is very good. See, once I decide the conclusion, I know which path to take. So first step is what? Deciding that conclusion. What is going to be my conclusion? And then thinking about the main body. You'll be adding in the themes that we are talking about. Like for example, everywhere I can talk about the agreement or disagreement, whether the choice is independent or not. Like for example, nation ka example lete hain. So if I talk about the nation, again it would be guided by historical factors. Like for example, India, when it was going for state reorganization, when it was deciding the framework of states, again what was the case? It had to be practical. India would have decided to radically alter the nature of the states. We could have decided we'll go for physiographic boundaries as states. But what we saw? We saw there were practical realities. First practical reality was after independence, when already there were British provinces, there were princely states, they had their own boundaries. That provided the first framework of how we'll be deciding or how we chose. Okay? We didn't have the resources to ultimately implement that basic idea, because even our planners knew that one of the best way is what? Physiography. Physiographic boundaries. Later, when there was state reorganization, first state reorganization being done, then again what? They chose the prevailing realities. And the prevailing reality was very clear that it was there was some kind of division in India on the basis of linguistic. Okay? So the choices would be what? No doubt there can be restriction. So when I'm talking in this framework, the examples that I'm talking about, again, I can talk about both the things, whether the choice is independent choice or not. Okay? So actually it becomes very complicated, because the system is like this, that it is we and our that future or whatever you call it. So our deeds are determining our future and or our status, and this future is determining what we are. Okay? So many times the situation which is there, that is what I said last part mein, ki it is all very complicated web. Okay? Because it is something like this working. See, ek cheez samajhna hoga tum logon ko. Ek minute sun lo meri baat. Meri baat pehle sun lo. You just listen to this. That you have to understand that in such type of subjective essays, in such type of abstract ideas, it is very difficult to arrive at the perfect aspect. Okay? We have to be what? Agar, if you just read the instructions which have been given by UPSC, usko padho, candidates may be required to write essay on multiple topics. They will be expected to keep closely to the subject of the essay, to arrange their ideas in orderly fashion, and to write concisely. Credit will be given for effective and exact expression. So, for what you are being rewarded? For being this kind of systematic in the line of thought. Okay? In such type of debates, these are what? Philosophical debates. And in these philosophical debates, there is no end to the debate. So, what I am just trying to tell you is, there can be n number of ideas with respect to these abstract statements. But here what we did, here the focus was on creation of my essay. Okay? And I feel this is the thing which is rewarding you. This will give you good marks rather than the perfect content of the essay. Because in such ideas, there is no perfect content. Everybody will have differing view. Like I said in the last part when we were talking about, that is what I was talking, that if you talk about the system is like this, there is an individual. Then, above this individual, there are organizations. Above this organization, organization is part of what? It is part of the society. If you talk about this part of the society, society is part of, there are, in an area, there can be more than one society. If you talk about an area, it is, areas are part of nations, and ultimately it is nations are making the world or humanity. So if you are an individual, you are affected by organizations, you are affected by society, you are affected by an area, you are affected by the nation's philosophy, you are affected by what we think as humans we are. And thus many times it can happen, the choices that we are making, they would be what? They might not be the independent choices. Okay? Because we are constrained by many of these aspects. Okay? So that is what I was coming to, that conclusion part. That you can ultimately take this conclusion. In the conclusion you can discuss that, this aspect as well. Okay? So that is, you can draw. Okay? You can draw. There is no limit. Because again, apply the same basic principle which we said first. It is a form of communication. UPSC ne kya likha? Apne ideas ko, how much you are able to systematically present. But don't make it too many, just make general diagrams. Okay? So again, this was just an example. And from this example, see, that is what I said, you will improve and you will keep on improving. If you keep on doing this, practice. But this practice has to be done. You learn how ultimately, okay, this is one way. I could have written this essay in another way also. I could have written two stories. Whole my essay could have been made up of two stories. And ultimately, or one story, where I am just trying to prove this statement. That whole story could have also been an essay. Okay? Although that method is a bit difficult in the initial phase. Writing that story, writing is a very difficult task. Okay? So, it is like this. This is what we call it as the brainstorming. And now you could see, when I arrived this, ab mujhe karna kya hai iske baad? I have to just write it in words. Words mein usse likh dena hai. And if I am writing it in words, I feel that a length of an essay should be not more than 1000 to 1200 words. One essay. Earlier when we had to write one essay only in 3 hours, then we were writing somewhere between 1600 to 2000 words. Today, you have to write two essays. And thus, the ideal length of the essay should be somewhere around this 1000 to 1200 words. Okay? So, if I have done this activity in 40 minutes, suppose that brainstorming activity, can I say in the next 40 minutes I should be able to write? I would be generally able to write. Because hum 40 minutes mein itna likh lete hain. When already we know, when we do not have to think much. Okay? So when we are writing essay, this is what we have to practice. This is what we have to learn. The brainstorming. And throughout these classes, what we'll be doing? We'll be doing this activity. We'll keep on brainstorming. We'll keep on arranging. So 30 minutes you will be getting proper for each of the essay. Then the teacher will discuss his idea on the essay. That how, and you can definitely, like you're discussing with me, you can discuss what you were thinking, because it is like one, when only one mind is thinking, the ideas do not flow that much. When many people are thinking, doing brainstorming, that is why there is group brainstorming idea. Okay? So that is one very important aspect that we have to take. Now, in this example, I can think about the conclusion. So conclusion humne pehle hi dekh liya. I have to also think about what? The introduction. First I think about the introduction. Can I say there can be number of ways of writing the introduction? Like for example, two ideas can be there, two ways of writing, and both are valid. It depends upon what is your preference. Like for example, can I say that one would have been, I could have simply explained the statement. Okay? So one of you were asking me, we are just writing examples. Okay? What could have been one way of starting? I could have explained what is the meaning of the statement. So I could have just given this idea that we as individuals, organizations, come a society, are ultimately what? Taking several actions. Actions. And these actions are what? These actions in turn, they determine what we become, what is our future, what would be the outcome. It is argued that there, if I want to be partially affirmative, there only I can put the idea. That it is argued that however, that individuals are what? Individuals, organization, they are not free in taking choices. But can I say that I will take the positive view? Isme mujhe positive view lena chahiye. And positive view is what? Positive view is the view of freedom. So at one level, you are actually, it is still your conscious choice. And this is the ideal view, which I should, if I was writing this ideal view, I will be taking up. That because there are both kind of examples. From the same slum, there are students who became IAS, while others could not. Conditions were same. That means at some point humans still have that choice. Okay? So can I explain this in the first one, two paragraphs? This basic idea, I can go for explanation. That is one way. Or can I say, I can start my introduction with an example, or I can start my example with a story. Like for example, I could have started a story, Mahabharat wala story bata sakta tha. What happened with the Kauravas? That could have been the story. Or example, for example, if I would have started with North Korea, South Korea example, that was also choice to me. And it was equally effective. If I am starting with example, then I will have to give this part. Okay? I will have to give this part and I will be writing after the introduction. I will be starting my main body with this explanation. So I can directly start with explanation, or I can take some example or stories, some kind of case. Okay? So introduction can be varied. We'll see different introduction with different type of topics. Sometimes the topics can be such that a historical introduction can also begin. Yahan par bhi, the example could have been historical example. Like we are giving the case of Mahabharata, or the, we are giving the case of the nations. So there can be historical examples. There can be contemporary examples. Variety of ways we can write. Here the statement was itself a statement. It was a quotation, a type of quotation. Okay? So again, I could have thought about another way could have been writing quotation. Okay? If you want to start with certain quotation, you know about that, about an eminent person, you can start with. It is not necessary that you write the name of that person. Okay? You can just start with statement itself. Okay? If you look into the orientation, I could have started with questions. Like you write introduction and you start with questions. Okay? There would be essays where that type of approach will become more valid. So anyway, there can be n number of ways in which we can start our introduction. Important thing is, don't become rigid while deciding introduction. It should be the nature of the essay which should decide your introduction. Okay? So pehle se hi soch ke nahi jana hai ki I'll be writing a story, I'll be writing this. Which essay you choosing, that should actually decide your introduction. Okay? So that is the nature of introduction. Introduction has to be, you have to remember, biggest blunder that you students are doing is, they move, shift away from the theme of the essay. Okay? Just now we saw the theme of the essay was what? Theme of the topic was, I don't have to talk about deed separately. I don't have to talk about the individual deed separately. Okay? All of these were making what? All of these were making one statement, one meaning. And that one meaning should be what? That should be the key in the whole essay. Starting from introduction to your main body. What has been asked should be answered. So one big problem in essays we very frequently find is, in your answers also, you shift away from what has been asked. You become too indirect. And that too indirect is not the desired form. I think I have given you before example, there was one essay I was writing on nationalism and globalism in the examination. And topic of the essay was nationalism versus globalism. This was the topic of the essay. When this topic is there, it is very clear, we don't have to write separately about nationalism. We don't have to write separately about globalism. It is nationalism versus globalism. Can I say in the introduction also, this is the same theme I will take up? So if I write introduction like this, I explain what is, suppose I take this approach of writing introduction, explanatory approach, the direct approach. If I take this approach of writing introduction, can I say I can go for what is nationalism, what is globalism? I'll first explain what is nationalism, what is globalism. But there are two ways in which I can do. One, I can write one paragraph explaining nationalism and other paragraph on explaining globalism without any linking word. Can I say? Karna wahi hai. But when I am writing, can I say I can add, on the other hand, globalism means this, this, this. So when I am writing like this, can I say I am adhering to the theme? The theme was versus. Or I can think of, suppose I am taking some example, I can start with example. So I can see that today in the world, there are some nations which are what? Which are becoming more nationalist in their approach. Like for example, Brexit. There is philosophy of nationalism which is dominating. While there are others who are talking more about what? Globalization. Like for example, when Trump is saying that India is, yesterday ka hi news tha, when India is ultimately following a very protectionist policy, he is talking about what? He is talking about globalism. Okay? So I can give example, but when you are giving example, you give both, because that versus is the key. So kehne ka simple matlab hai ki there are three parts in the essay: introduction, main body and conclusion. And in introduction and main body, you cannot shift away from the theme. This is a rule. It is a simple rule. You cannot move away from the theme in the introduction and the main body. They have to be what has been asked. So I use this statement again and again when I'm taking classes. Introduction and main body are examiner space. While if you talk about the conclusion, your space is conclusion. So if you want to say something which is not directly asked, something visionary, something which is beyond what has been asked, the only space that is left to you is what? It is conclusion. In the introduction, you cannot do anything. So writing an essay, writing an answer is what? It is like putting a nail in wall. So when I am putting a nail in wall, I hit on the nail first. Okay? Sabse pehle jab hum nail put karte hain wall mein, what we make? Can I say hum ek bar dheere se maarte hain? So that there is a space made. That is what we do. And once the space is made, where we have to put the nail, then we start hitting fast. Yehi karte hain. Finally, in the conclusion, what we do? We finally hit hardest. This is all your essay writing and your answer writing. So introduction is what? It is that area where you are making space for your, you are introducing the idea. It can be in many ways. It can even be a summary. Like in when we are explaining, we were explaining the summary of the essay. What our essay is going to be. But it has to introduce the idea, main theme. If you drift away from the main theme, if you start doing like this, this, again, your marks would be like that only. You'll be getting low marks. So in the introduction, you have to closely keep with the theme. Only place you can bit drift, and I'm saying bit drift, from the theme is the conclusion part. Nowhere else. There also, the conclusion should be such that, so that is the nature of introduction. Okay? Main body, it is very much clear, like we said, very important thing when we are writing main body is that the ideas are connected to each other. Okay? They shouldn't be like mechanical approach. And that is why we many times ask students to avoid writing headings. Because when you are writing headings, it looks mechanical. Although you can combine headings and still you can write in such a manner using the words where there is connectivity. Okay? So problem of one idea can pave the reason for emergence of the other idea. So there should be what? There should be connectivity within the main body. And like here we saw, there was what? There is a hierarchy. Hierarchy of ideas that I have to follow. When we are writing main body, that hierarchy of ideas is very, very important. We have to adhere to that hierarchy of ideas. Okay? So, like for example, we said, here, agar ye koi dusra hota, essay, I could have went from macro to micro. But here the statement was more meaning, or a normal person would interpret the statement as individual. So what we did, we went from micro to macro. Okay? It was making more sense. But the sequence was very clear. Agar main, suppose, individual ke baad seedha nation likh deta, aur baad mein likhta society, baad mein likhta organization, usse pehle likh deta humanity. Again, the flow of ideas wouldn't have been so structured. So main body has to be what? It has to be very structured, where the ideas are interlinked to each other and there is a kind of hierarchy which is made. As we said, when you are writing main body, one of the best things we see today which is fetching you marks, it is examples and some kind of stories, some kind of even quotations. Even you can give some informations, because a statement said with something, some evidence, has more power than a statement just spoken generally. So if possible, what I will do, if I have, I will also keep on providing examples and evidences for the idea which I am putting forward through my entire main body. That means, when I'm writing a theme, that theme should be supported by an evidence or an example. Okay? Or an story, whatever I want. So that is another thing that I have to follow, main body. Then if you talk about conclusion, there can be in many ways conclusions can be written. Conclusion should be, agar simple bhasha mein bole to, conclusion should be the place where I am summing up what I have said. Okay? It is the outcome of what we were talking about. Okay? Now these outcomes can be number of things. I can be more negative in the conclusion. I can talk about some danger which exists. In the conclusion, I can just simply sum up that this is the reason, and thus, like in this, it was like we could have just summed up. Or conclusion can be also, after summing up, I can go beyond, I can give some kind of suggestion, some kind of future direction. Okay? Like here we were trying to give future direction, because humanity's existence depends upon what? It depends upon individuals. So we have to make correct choices as individuals. We have to make correct choices as the societies. Okay? So again, it can be some kind of suggestive statement. So that is one way in which our conclusions can be written. So this is the normal nature of how I will be writing. In the conclusion also, you can also put a question. Basic thing is, I am just putting those ideas. So it can be that, like something like, if we continue like this, what will be the future? It is for us to think. A simple question, and again it is powerful. Okay? Basic idea is, I am trying to here talk about the threat that exists. So it can be even that you have to make it, see, as I said before, there is no fixed rules. The only thing is fixed is objective. And if you talk about the objective, objective is what? I have to make my essay interesting. I have to write in such a manner that when a person reads, he is captured and he is not bored as he passes from one statement to other. His curiosity keeps on increasing. Okay? That is how we have to essentially write our essays. Now, two things when we are writing our essay, even in the essay, you can do one thing is, you have to be simple in writing. Okay? Write in simplified manner. Okay? And simplification, if you talk about it, does not mean using lighter vocabulary. You can use heavy vocabulary. Okay? Heavy vocabulary can be used. Okay? What is then simplicity? Simplicity is that my statements are small. I have to make the sentences smaller. So very important rule that you have to follow while you are writing essays, do not write long sentences. Do not write long sentences. Okay? This is what you have to follow. There is no other choice that is there with you. So do not write long sentences, because if you have to take example, you buy Bear Act, Constitution aata hai, Bear Act, usko padho, and you read a book like, aur dusra ek example leta hun, jaake DD Basu kareed lao, there is another polity book, and you compare it with Lakshmikant, which is better? You'll be finding that Lakshmikant is much better. Why? Because it is not going into that long, long sentences and explaining the phenomena. It is simplifying. It is breaking the ideas into small, small sentences. Okay? So very frequently it happens that our writing has become too complex. And we have to think on those lines that if we are writing too long sentences, aisa hota hai ki person, by the time he is reading the full sentence, wo pehla idea bhool chuka hai. Theek hai? So that is one thing. Okay, that is one thing that I have to know. Also, simplicity would mean that my paragraphs should also be not very long. They should not be very long. So that means if suppose hum jaise apne example mein kar rahe the, we were doing in one idea that we were putting, there were many things. Ab un sabko ek hi paragraph mein likh dun, to can I say it would become too long? It would become too long. And you take two type of writing, in which one is small paragraphs, other is very long paragraphs. Can I say long wala padhne mein halat kharab ho jata hai? Theek hai? So I have to think about my reader. If I'm writing too long sentences, he would not enjoy the process. I have to make him enjoy the process. And how it would be done? By ensuring that the paragraph's lengths are smaller. Approximate, if I talk about, on a page which you are getting in UPSC, there can be 2 to 3 paragraphs on a page, depending upon what is the idea. So the ideal is between 2 to 3 paragraphs. ठीक है, अगर एक पेज में एक ही पैराग्राफ है, that is something which becomes, वो देखने में अच्छा नहीं लगता, पढ़ने में there is problem. ठीक है, so on a page 2 to 3 paragraphs, that is a kind of ideal kind of situation. It would not be too small and it would not be too long. The optimum size of the paragraphs would be something like this. Now when I am saying that, when suppose हम individual के बारे में लिख रहे थे, एक example लेते हैं, when we were writing about that individual case, so we were writing about Gandhi, we were writing about Hitler. ठीक है, अब इन दोनों को एक साथ मिला के लिख दूंगा तो paragraph लंबा हो गया, but the case was, this was one idea I was writing. I have to show to the examiner, I have to make the task of the reader easy. ठीक है, now to do this there are two ways. One is the mechanical way, other is the flowing way. So mechanical way is, I actually write an heading and then within that heading I write those paragraphs. This is one way. At points you will find it would be valid in type, some types of essays. ठीक है, but it is, it gives that kind of mechanical outlook. So a better way is also available, which will give us this same effect, but it would be less mechanical. And what is this? Now suppose I am writing my essay like this. Here a new paragraph is there. ठीक है, similarly if I just say here another new paragraph has started. ठीक है, these two belong to same idea and from here a new idea has begun. ठीक है, can I say I can here make a box about the key theme when I'm using that? So I'm writing, as an individual we have choices to make which determine our deeds. So वो individual जैसे ही मैंने लिखा उसको क्या किया, box में बना दिया. ठीक है, so what happens, this becomes my main heading. So heading sentence के अंदर ही मैंने क्या कर दिया, heading बना दिया. Important keywords I can underline them so that the reader, for the reader it becomes easy. So I made this heading. When I'm starting a new idea, similarly, as an organizations also have their own choices available. So as I am writing organizations, again a new heading. It is paragraph, but I have incorporated that heading aspect just by using some symbols. So wherever possible, what you do, you will use this symbols, you will highlight the keywords. That has to be done. ठीक है, basic idea is same, it is guided by the same aspect that I have to make the reader comfortable, feel happy. ठीक है, so that is the aspect of simplicity and presentation. Okay? Now, if you talk about presentation, I feel because our idea was simple that writing is basically what? It has to be, it is communication. It is a form of communication. I am communicating an idea. So it has to be what? Can I say, jo UPSC ne likha hua hai, clearly presented. It has to be very clearly presented. That means I can make the reader more clear about my idea. And if this is the ultimate objective, can I say, I can use, if required, I can use diagrams. If required, I can use diagrams. There is no problem in use of diagrams. Although, because traditionally we think that essays are like kind of writing, mostly. So, don't make too many diagrams. One, two at places, like humne jo apne point mein, humne apne essay mein dekha, last mein ek jagah ban rahi thi, jahan par actually, if I would have presented that diagram, jo humne society, individual, jo diagram banaya, can I say, it would make the reader, it would give the reader very clear picture what I am trying to say. Okay? So if it is needed, then you make the diagram. Don't force diagrams for the sake of diagrams. That was the place where it was kind of needed. So there, no problem, you make diagram. Okay? Diagrams can be made in the essay, no problem in that. If I am talking about certain area, okay? I can, agar mujhe zarurat hai, toh main map bhi bana sakta hun. If that is clearly showing what I am talking about. Okay? But generally hum map vagera avoid karte hain. So general diagrams should be the one approach that we should be following. Now also few important things when you are talking about the sentences. In sentences, you try to be more in writing in active speech. Your speech should be what? It should be more active speech rather than passive speech. Passive speech becomes more complicated. Okay. Linking ke liye, you must be knowing that you have to use, keep on using conjunctions and some linking words. Conjunctions and some linking words. So, jaise abhi maine ek example liya, on the other hand. It is what? It is two, three words, but it changed wholly how the essay will look. So, I have to keep on doing this kind of activity. So, as I said, suppose I am writing about approach, essay on some approach. I can talk about one approach, I can talk about problem of this approach, and then I can move on and say, thus this approach becomes relevant, and I can explain that approach. So there what will happen? Again that linking would be there. Okay? So that linkage, that flow has to be there. Sometimes just by use of few words that linkage can come. Okay? I have to keep that in my mind when I am writing. We will be doing. Abhi hum bahut sare essay karne wale hain. We are just here talking about some principles. Okay? Throughout we will be talking about this, these things. Okay? So, this is the general nature of the general principles that will be followed. As I said, there can be n number of approaches, there can be n number of ways of writing essays. Important thing is what we said first. And what was that? You have to start writing, and with start writing and practice, what I have to do? Ultimately, I have to develop my own approach. This is where I have to reach. Everyone will have its his own approach. Some of you might not be. Ho sakta hai. I have seen many scientific-minded students, they are not very comfortable in writing the philosophical essays. Because that bent of mind is missing. There is something which we call it as left bent mind or right bent mind. So some people might be more right bent. Some would be more left bent. So in that case, you will see that you will have your own idea, your own approach. Where you are more comfortable, where you feel more comfortability. Within your comfortability, you are also making the reader comfortable. Comfortability is the key. You are also comfortable, reader is also comfortable. That is what we have to essentially do. That is all essay writing about. So many essays we'll be practicing. There is, as we said, every day you'll be practicing, Saturday, Sunday. Two essays on Saturday, two essays on Sunday. Today was the general class. So because of that, we just talked about one essay. But this half an hour activity, you will be getting to do. And after even the classes are over, you have to keep on doing. This is something which is like, it should be second nature to us. So we'll stop for today. And because I have a class today in Mukherjee Nagar, it was designed like this, I had to shift it early because of something. So that is about the general things about the essay. From next, tomorrow, I will not be here. Tomorrow there would be Vivek sir, he will be taking some essays on IR topic. So he will be talking about what is the general nature of when you are writing IR based essays, what are the principles that you have to adhere to, and he will be taking two topics of contemporary some issue, and he will be discussing, giving you that 30 minutes for brainstorming, then he will tell you how that brainstorming should have been done. As I said, there is no rule. Rule is comfortability. That it would be determined by the type approach you are adopting. If sometimes the approach is story, you can use first or second, no problem. It depends upon what is your approach.